Shimon, showtime.
Take five competitive cooks.
That wasn't me.
You clean it all up for Mummy.
Blend together over five nights.
Okay, this is scary.
Add secret scoring. The result?
It's a caterpillar.
Are you serious?
Lucky meals.
There was no way I was going to eat that.
Oh, no.
Chatty conduct.
You need to find yourself a man.
Shimon.
That noise really irritates me.
Really?
And batty behaviour.
I've had my hair done.
As they compete to win a £1,000 prize.
That was better than yours.
It's day three in Croydon, a place where pop star chum lover man Dane Bowers learnt his trade.
So this is the showroom.
And hoping to take her dinner party to another level is tonight's host, Vanessa D'Souza.
I think my night's definitely going to be the classiest of nights, let's just say. I've got good food and lots of alcohol, so hopefully it'll be a normal, refined, posh dinner party.
Well, if it's refinement you're after, look no further than Monday night's host, Keith Freddy.
My entertainment, hello. You can't beat Tina Turner and them high heels that I was wearing. That's got to be a 12+, isn't it, points?
Apparently not. And you get scored on your food as well, which simply wasn't the best, leaving you with a meagre 22.
This might be a little bit hot for me.
With his hosting over, last night Keith turned picky guest.
If I eat any more of that, I probably will be ill tomorrow.
I think if anyone's going to criticise, it'll be Keith. And I think he has no right to do so. And if he does, I'll put him in his place.
I've just got some mint dip. Would you like some?
And Keith's pickiness didn't get past last night's host, Susie Phillips, either.
I'll decline, please. He's got yoghurt and it's a bit too rich for me.
I think Keith's a bit of a drama queen. He said the falafels were too hot.
That's a caterpillar.
Oh, that's not a caterpillar.
And also about a fly. Yes, he did seem to be picking on me a bit.
But it was a different species that put off Thursday's... host Sarah Marie Palmer.
It's got red eyes, it's evil. This is some demonic house. This is a demonic house.
I just saw eyes everywhere and fur and just things pouncing and I couldn't even get a good look at what they were.
They were cats.
I was slightly traumatised by last night and I wouldn't be going back to that house again. It's just far too creepy. Far too creepy.
All right, I heard you the first time.
I think my guests do now think I'm a mad cat lady, I'm afraid.
I'm afraid you're not wrong. Nevertheless, Susie leads by a whisker with 23 points.
And you show up and ruin it for me.
Can we try acting now?
For God's sakes.
And Friday night's host, Amdram director and vegetarian Robert Preston, can't wait to see what's on offer from this evening's host.
I hope Vanessa's going to reveal herself a bit more tonight.
I bet you do.
Vanessa's kind of a well-turned-out girl. I reckon she's probably got a good menu. She strikes me as being the one out of the five of us that is actually capable of cooking.
That is the idea of the competition.
So far, Keith's food was pretty abysmal. Susie's was OK, but I hope that I can produce sort of Michelin-star standard food.
Well, the proof will be in the pudding, or the starter, of spicy baked crab with a spicy baked potato for the vegetarians. Spicy.
Crab? Never had crab before, so that'd be interesting, breaking its arms or legs, but I will be wearing my gloves, definitely. The only problem I have is it's spicy. That's the only reason why we're not be able to eat it.
I'm going to cut some green and red chilli. I actually don't know how hot these are, so Keith might have a field day tonight.
Oh, dear. She adds her chopped chilli to mashed crab meat.
It's time to get messy. It's not a brilliant job, and I've had to get rid of my nails for it. Not very glamorous, I must say.
Most inconvenient! Vanessa adds mayonnaise.
Oh. That wasn't me.
Didn't say it was.
OK, I'm now going to spice it up, specially for Keith, with some pepper sauce.
Bad luck, Keith. Whoa, steady on!
Looks like a bloodbath, doesn't it?
You said it.
OK, that's now hot.
Funny, that.
Very hot indeed, actually.
She finishes by adding chopped onions and seasoning.
Keith better not say that there's no seasoning in this, because I've seasoned that to death now. So if he even tries to touch that salt and pepper on the table, that's it, hell will break loose.
Uh-oh. Next, she gets on with the potatoes for her vegetarian starter.
Spicy baked potato. I don't have any strong feelings about that one way or the other. It's a spicy baked potato. Great.
Yeah, well, thanks for coming. Vanessa mashes potatoes and mixes with mashed sweet potato.
Looks a little bit vile at this stage. A little bit, like, sick, to be honest.
Yum, yum.
Hopefully she's done it really nicely. I like spicy food, and hopefully it'll be a little bit different to a standard jacket potato.
It looks like texturised thick now.
That different enough for you, Susie? Vanessa adds chilies, garlic puree and onion, and puts to one side to grill later in fancy individual portions.
This is exactly the sort of thing I expected from Vanessa, as it's really posh and sort of restaurant quality, and she's quite a restaurant quality bird.
Yeah, a quality bird who's going to be serving up some quality wines.
We've got a fantastic Chateauneuf du Pape here. It's a food wine as well, it's perfect for beef.
I know it well.
Yeah, you know that, yeah.
Yeah, same here, lovely drop.
Very vanilla-like.
Yeah, it's a little bit of red fruit there, red cherry.
Yeah, plum, raspberry, watermelon.
Tonight, I think it's going to be quite classy, quite formal, everything very beautiful, very meticulous, which is lovely. However, I'm not really a formal, elegant, meticulous type of girl.
I'm not sure my guests are into many flavours. I don't think they know the difference, but hopefully I can educate them tonight.
Good luck with that. With her vintage wines in hand, Vanessa heads off home to prepare her main course. Medallions of beef, and for the vegetarians, a corn potato cake, both served with champ. That's mashed potato to you and me.
Beef, I love roast beef.
It's a steak, Keith, not a roast.
I like beef. I like it when it's sort of cooked properly. I don't like it when it's too pink, so I'm hoping that she does ask us how we like our beef.
More potato, more corn.
The vegetarians are kind of being overloaded with carbs today.
You're not kidding.
But what do you expect? If you're going to be a vegetarian, can't not expect to have carbicide on a night.
Who'd be a vegetarian? I don't know.
Well, you, apparently. For her veggie main, Vanessa fries off some corn with onions.
I personally really don't like corn. It just tastes of nothing, absolutely nothing. It's a really bad substitute for mince, I think.
Bon appetit, fella! She spoons her corn into mashed potato parcels and seals with a lid before giving it a little spank.
With the spanking, I'm just doing whatever it takes to get it in shape.
You saucy little minx! She then dips her vegetarian offerings in egg.
What a messy job.
Rolls in breadcrumbs and sets aside to be fried later, along with the beef. Last thing to prepare for the main is the champ.
I think champ might be short for champagne.
Wrong. It's just more potato.
Oh, God, there's loads of potato. There's loads of potato in here. There's the baked potato to start, and then potato in the corn cake, and potato with the champ.
Champ is a word that I've made up.
No, you haven't.
Because they're champion potatoes.
It's also an Irish dish, mash with onions, which is basically what you've got with a massive dollop of butter. Champ complete, she moves on to her dessert. Chocolate and orange liqueur souffle. Always a tricky dish.
I don't know what souffle is.
It's a sort of light and fluffy thing, Keith.
That's at the bottom, liqueur souffle. It's obviously a kind of drink.
It isn't.
No, I haven't. Or I might have done, but sometimes I have drinks, I don't even know what they are, I just drink them, so I have no idea. I'll try anything once.
It'll be the last time you try and drink a souffle. Vanessa adds cream to melted butter along with sugar.
It's the actual souffle that's worrying me, because pretty much 90% of the time, most people can't get a souffle to rise. So if I can be the minority, I'll be very happy.
I think she's really brave doing that, because of course it could totally collapse, so that's really brave.
Vanessa continues her gutsy dessert by adding her souffle mix to melted chocolate, along with orange liqueur and egg yolks, before leaving to cool. She'll bake it later, just before serving. And with her prep done, she's got just enough time to get changed before her first guest arrives. Straight talking Sarah Marie.
Hello.
Shall I take my shoes off?
No, keep them on.
Are you sure?
Yep, keep them on.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Take a seat if you want, or stand.
Or have a lie down. Next in, it's Pussy Galore, Susie.
Hello. Wow, don't you look fantastic?
Oh, you look fantastic too.
Oh, no, you do.
Thank you. Oh, you look gorgeous.
Thank you. Please excuse me.
Next up, it's...
Rob! Wow, don't you look fab?
Oh, not as fab as you.
Oh, thank you.
Ugh, bit creepy.
Hey!
Hey!
How smart are you?
Yeah, it's my one suit.
Oh, you pull it off very well.
Thank you.
Weddings, funerals, job interviews. Last to arrive, it's Mr. Picky Eater himself, Keith McBrady. And I've no idea why either.
Wow, Keith. You look...
Lost?
Fantastic.
Thank you very much.
I was not expecting that.
Oh, wow!
Whoa.
Hello! Have you got any Scottish in you?
No, I haven't.
Would you like some?
Oh, awkward.
I don't know how to answer that one.
Nothing wrong with a man wearing a kilt. I'm not Scottish, but you don't have to be Scottish to wear a kilt. I feel very comfortable wearing this.
That'll be the sporran doing its job.
So, to good food, good wine, and good company. Please have a good night. Thank
you. Coming up, a meaty argument.
Don't worry, you haven't got any beef.
Oh. It's a little bit deceitful.
I just think that's a bit weird.
Relationship revelations.
You need to stop focusing on these cats. You need to find yourself a man.
And seasoned reasoning.
You didn't put any salt in the food.
I actually did. Are you trying to indicate that I haven't seasoned my food?
After years of giving everyone else advice, Sarah Beeny is in trouble with the council over her restoration project.
As a self-proclaimed property expert, we would have expected Sarah Beeny to have known that she should have had these consents in place.
Stuff them, because we're going to do these rooms regardless.
Beeny's Restoration Nightmare. Available on 4OD.
I'm scouring Britain for ideas and inspiration for my recipes. I'm going to show you how centuries of foreign influences have changed the whole landscape of what we eat and how we eat it. We're like a magpie nation. We're not too proud to say, I'm going to have a go at that and I'm going to make it my own.
Oh,
yeah. Jamie's Great Britain, available on 4OD.
A story over 100 years in the making, told in an evening. Hardy's Nottage Hill, proud sponsors of Come Dine With Me.
Like wearing kilts.
Tonight, food snob Vanessa D'Souza is hosting a dinner party for four guests who'll score her efforts at the end of the night. They'll each take turns to cook, with the top scorer winning £1,000 at the end of the week. While Vanessa gets her starters in the oven, Sarah Marie and Susie head upstairs to root round her drawers.
Oh, oh gosh, I thought it was one of your cats.
Why would it be in there?
What's this?
To practice extensions, is it?
Oh, I've had my hair done. I've got lots of extensions and it was very, very expensive.
Now I can see your lips moving.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I've never known anyone to have that much makeup. I'd say she's got well over £500 worth of makeup and accessories here, definitely.
Oh, gosh, they're so thick.
You'd look good in these.
Oh, thank you. I don't know, I might have to try some on. Now I've seen you in them and Vanessa.
Do you have to stick them on? You stick them on with glue.
Can you get them off?
Yeah.
It's not super glue.
We should get her to put some on you later.
Well, only if you eat all your dinner up. Now get downstairs. The food's nearly ready. Steady.
And she does it.
Nice work. So there it is. Spicy baked crab with a spicy baked potato for the vegetarians. Let's hope it's not too spicy for Keith.
Right, is there chilies inside it?
Yes, there is.
It's hot chili, I think.
Yeah, it's pretty spicy, but, I mean, if you don't like it, that's fine. Just leave it.
Sarah, could you please pass me the salt and pepper?
Yeah, that'll cool it down a bit.
Thank you very much.
Oh, Keith, I should probably say there's quite a bit of seasoning on it already, so...
Yes. Yep, salt and pepper.
On the salad already and the crab, but go ahead.
Thank you.
He hadn't even touched the food, and he was adding salt and pepper to it. Are you trying to sort of indicate that I haven't seasoned my food? And I added extra seasoning.
Well, at least he's eating the garnish.
I was disappointed because I was expecting to see a crab. I think if I'd seen the crab, I would probably have made more effort to eat the crab, crunch it up and everything else. But to me, that wasn't a crab because it was crab paste, so it wasn't really the same.
It's exactly the same, and he'd still have smothered it in salt. At least the veggies seem happy.
Spicy baked potato. So there's me expecting a jacket, you know, with a bit of Tabasco in it. And, of course, she hits me with whatever that was.
Potato?
I don't know what it was, but it was great. I like that a lot, yeah.
Yeah, potato. Time for a spot of wine appreciation.
There's a lot of sort of citrus fruits in it, apples.
For someone who doesn't really drink wine, I think that's really lovely, because most wine to me tastes like vinegar and cat wee.
Well, you'd know.
It's really nice. Oh,
so you drink all your cat wee? Oh my,
you know, but you can smell it. It's like perfume, can't you?
No, I don't drink cat wee.
Yeah.
No.
What do you do, Keith?
I was amazed, actually, because it had really lovely flavours. It was not... I didn't taste any vinegar or cat wee or anything like that. It was just sort of fruity and refreshing and really nice.
Just where exactly have you been buying your wine? What you got going on, Keith? Citrus? Apples?
I'll take your word for it. It's got all them bits in it. It's nice. Just slides down.
Yeah.
Nice and soft.
Like liquid.
You know, goes down the throat. Okay. Could have said something a little bit nicer, especially if you're not going to eat my food. But, we'll see how he gets on with the main meal. No doubt he'll have something to say about how that's cooked. I'm about to cook the main meal. I know you guys are having vegetarian.
Mmm, more potato.
How would you like your beef? Your little steak. It's like a steak, so...
Can I have my medium going towards well done?
Okay, cool. Do you want to see any pink?
No, I do want to see pink, just a little bit.
Tiny bit, okay.
Rare, please.
You want it rare? Okay, just blue or just rare?
Just about 3 minutes each side, you know.
I shall time it with an egg timer. And yours shall be out shortly, don't worry. You haven't got any beef.
Oh.
Would you like some?
Yeah, if you got some.
Would you?
Yeah, I'd love some.
You're a vegetarian!
You can't just change your mind.
Vegetarian eats beef.
Yeah.
Interesting.
What a surprise.
What a strange vegetarian.
Who knew? What a surprise.
I sprung on everyone that I do eat a bit of cow, and when I heard that cow was being served up, I wanted in on that action.
So basically, you've been lying all week.
By Rob coming out saying he's not a vegetarian, when I did the impression he was, it's a little bit deceitful.
I don't know. I just think that's a bit weird.
If you're doing two steaks, you can do a third steak.
Actually, she was doing three steaks and she hasn't got a fourth.
Rob, who is apparently a vegetarian, has decided he'd quite like to try some steak. That's absolutely fine. It's completely my mistake for only buying three and not accounting for any mishaps.
Or part-time vegetarians.
So what I'm going to do is to give him my steak and to make myself another vegetarian option.
So Robert is now getting a meat and a vegetarian option, leaving Vanessa to painstakingly make another potato cake.
You know who I'll be thinking about when this happens.
That naughty vegetarian! She fries off the potato cakes alongside her steaks, and 40 minutes later...
Oh, done! Finally!
Medallions of beef! And if anyone is still a vegetarian, a corn potato cake, both served with champ.
I'm serving myself first, because I want you to know that I'm having a vegetarian main meal too, so... Yeah, no steak for me.
Vanessa went for the vegetarian option herself, I think that's because she's a girl that likes to watch her weight.
No, it's because you selfishly nicked the last steak.
I think that's maybe why she went for that.
And Rob, my dear, you have the ultimate steakout. Wow. You have veggie and meat.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you. This Enjoy. Looks like it's going to be a clean plate scenario.
I hope so. Please have
anyone seen the salt? Oh, Keith's got it.
That's a lot of salt.
Yeah, but you didn't put any salt in the food.
I actually did.
You just told me you didn't. You did? Okay, never mind.
Did I say I didn't put salt in the food?
I didn't hear you.
Ah, might have been the actual starter.
No, she seasoned that as well.
I do like a lot of salt, but I don't cook with salt, so I put salt on afterwards.
Well, you didn't cook it, Keith.
It was sort of quite small and petite. I finished it in a couple of minutes, because I was quite hungry because I hadn't had the starter.
You mean you didn't eat the starter?
I didn't want to be rude and say, can I have some more, please, because that might have come across as being a bit rude.
What, like dousing it all in salt?
Vanessa's food is really sort of like fine dining, especially with vegetarian food, because some people just sort of, you know, they're not really used to vegetarian food, but she's actually done a really good job.
The beef seems to be going down all right with your fellow veggie as well.
It was a good bit of cow. It was, The meat option was as good as the veggie option.
Well, how nice you got to sample both. Time for the turncoat to explain himself.
I don't eat animals that make me laugh.
Right.
What?
I think it's back to, like, my childhood. Like, I used to, like, be down, like, the seaside on the family holiday. There'd be these crabs walking sideways, and you just sort of go up to them and, like, have a bit of a play with a crab. But cows, they just stand there. You can go up to a cow with a nail gun and shoot it in the head, and it won't know what's going on.
Not sure that's strictly true.
So what would a pig do?
They're intelligent. It goes human, dolphin, monkey, pig. They're intelligent creatures. I could never eat a pig, and I don't.
Well, that's clear, then.
It seems that as long as the food makes him laugh, he won't kill it and he won't eat it. So, that's obviously a good reason for him.
And apparently there's a good reason why you haven't found love, according to Sarah Marie.
You've got a very beautiful face, but it would be nice to see something enhanced in you, because you need to get out there and get a man and stop focusing on these cats. Because when you're old and sick in bed, these cats are not going to be cooking you dinner. Yeah, you need to find yourself a man.
Who doesn't mind sharing the bed with 10 cats? Right on cue, Vanessa's on hand with her cosmetic bag for an impromptu makeover.
OK, so I'm just going to put a little bit of powder on, if that's OK.
You already look a bit like Kylie Minogue.
She should be so lucky.
So I think she's probably maybe going to work towards that as well.
She won't recognise herself if she looks like Kylie. High five to the lashes.
Lashes, Keith.
Lashes, Rob.
Yeah, Shimon.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new and improved Shimon Susie.
Out the way, Kylie. I can't see Susie.
I wasn't sure how Susie took it, because obviously Vanessa targeted her. Like, I'm going to give you a makeover. Or why not anyone else? What's wrong with her?
I think you made that perfectly clear.
I personally wish she did it on me so I could go home with some expensive eyelashes.
Well, you'll have to make do with a souffle. Time for Vanessa's risky dessert. She whisks egg whites with icing sugar and folds in the chocolate mix she prepared earlier.
I hope that my guests appreciate how much skill it takes to make a souffle and make a good one at that.
I doubt it. She spoons into chilled ramekins and bakes for 10 minutes.
They've bloody risen all right.
Who's a clever girl, then? So there it is, chocolate and orange liqueur souffle. A first for Keith, apparently.
It's light. It's not deep chocolate or heavy. It's light. That was.
That's what souffle means, yeah. Mm-hmm.
As I believe William Shakespeare once said, om nom nom.
And as I believe Linda McCartney once said, don't eat beef.
Because I've never had a souffle before,
yeah.
I was sort of unaware how the system works. So obviously, I just put a bit on my plate first. Because I mixed the sauce in it and I'm just eating it step by step.
Classy to the end. Wipe your mouths, everyone. It's time to go.
The souffle was interesting. I've never had it before. I don't think I'd probably have it again. It wasn't to my taste.
It was just like chocolate sex going on in my mouth. It was well nice.
I think I'll avoid you on Easter Sunday.
I can finally give myself a little pat on the back. I've worked hard and I hope it's paid off.
It did get a bit girly with the makeover, so tonight I'm going to give Vanessa an 8.
Oh, you meat-eating animal!
Tonight I'll be giving Vanessa a 7.
The food was brilliant, everything worked out really well, very high standard, and she gave me a makeover, so I'm going to give her a 10.
Wow, thanks, Kylie!
The food was good, there wasn't enough of it, could have done with some more.
You didn't eat half of it.
No entertainment, and the ambience was quite flat, so tonight I'm going to give Vanessa a 6.
So, despite picky Keith's complaints and catering for a turncoat vegetarian, Vanessa leaps into the lead with an impressive 31. Next time, classy cooking.
That's the posh way of doing it.
A sweaty soiree.
He
was getting redder and redder and redder and sweatier and sweatier.
And attention-seeking antics.
Keith is really frustrating me. He's just too attention-seeking and, you know, taking up sort of too much of the limelight.